And welcome Prime Minister Gary Bush on his first official visit to Brussels.
The partnership between the European Union and Georgia is strong. Today we reflected on the progress we have made and looked ahead to the future of this very broad and deep relationship. We discussed a wide range of issues covering all aspects of our extensive engagement. One of our main objectives this year is to sign the association agreement, including the deep and comprehensive free trade area, which we initialed in Vilnius last November. We agreed on the need to respect sovereign countries' freedom of choice on foreign policy, regional economic cooperation, and trade. The Prime Minister informed me about the major changes that have taken place recently in Georgian politics. A new president, a new prime minister, and a new constitution. I encourage Georgia to continue to pay attention to political pluralism and media freedom, and criminal prosecutions have to be evidence-based, impartial, and fully in line with democratic values. The European Union places a high importance on the rights of people belonging to minorities. The adoption of the anti-discrimination law is important in order to make progress in the visa liberalization dialogue. The European Union welcomes the signing of a framework participation agreement on the so-called CSDP cooperation, which will enhance our cooperation on common security and defense policy and enable Georgia's participation in EU-led crisis management operations. The Prime Minister informed me about recent developments in conflict resolution in Georgia. The European Union welcomes the continuing diplomatic contacts between Georgia and the Russian Federation as an important contribution to assuring stability and security for the region. I expressed the Union's concern at ongoing activities to erect physical barriers to free movement within the Georgian territory. I reconfirmed the Union's support for Georgia's territorial integrity and our commitment to support conflict resolution in Georgia, including through our co-chairmanship of the Geneva International Talks and our monitoring mission in Georgia. To conclude, let me once again, Mr. Prime Minister, thank you for your visit and for your efforts to advance the political association and economic integration with the European Union, and I will be glad to visit Tbilisi in the upcoming months. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Mr. President. We had a very fruitful and interesting meeting with President Rompuy. Georgia is irreversibly following the European integration course, which is a cornerstone of its foreign as well as domestic policy. It is a national idea supported by the Georgian people and all major political parties. We share the common European values and are determined to continue the unwavering path of democratic development in order to ultimately anchor our country to the European and Euro-Atlantic institutions. We are confident that reforms implemented according to the European integration agenda are essential for genuine modernization and Europeanization of our country. And therefore, the Georgian government is ready to deliver on its commitments, in particular, accelerating reforms and approximation with the European norms and policies. Currently, the Eastern Partnership is the most efficient policy framework for Georgia to achieve the ever closer relationship with the European Union. And in this context, we are ready to work closely with our partners in Brussels, as well as in each and every European capital, in order to secure and guarantee the success of this initiative. We also discussed the association agreement. Mr. President confirmed that we will be able to sign the association agreement in August, and I would like to once again confirm the readiness of our country to sign this agreement in August. Thank you very much again, Mr. President.